Class today we are going to study about a little more about the adjectives. First one we are going to study demonstrative adjective. Demonstrative adjective, as it is self-explanatory, it is telling about that what has been demonstrated. It means whenever some noun has been demonstrated, then those words will be used as demonstrative adjective. Let's look some words. These words are this, that, these and those. Again I am telling, this, that, these and those. These are some words. These are some words by which we can demonstrate any noun. Let me give you one example. When some table is there, okay, this is the table, this is the blackboard. If I am saying that this blackboard is good, this time I am using in the sentence, this blackboard is good. It means I am talking about the blackboard and I am also denoting, I am also indicating where the blackboard is. So it means we are allocating the thing and we are also telling about that thing. Let me tell you one more example. Like I am having any pencil and I say this pencil is very long. So the word this is telling, the word this is indicating that I am having that pencil with me very near. It means if something that is very near to us, we will use this. And if there are many in the plural, then we use these. Okay, this is used for the thing which is near to us, that is used for the thing which is far to us, these is used for many things, those who are near to us, and those is used for the things, those who are far. Aaya samajh mein? Understood everyone?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, all right. So, well, we know that this, that, these, those, only these words are the demonstrative adjectives. So, how many demonstrative adjectives we came to know? Four only. How many? Four. Okay. Now, there is a little more added about this. Typically, although not always, adjectives come before the noun, they are modifying. With demonstrative adjectives, it's a sure bet. It means whenever demonstrative adjective will be written, they will always come before the noun. Like this boy, this blackboard, this table, that table, these boys, those teachers, that teacher. So, always any noun will come with some demonstrative noun. Is it clear, class?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, look at this. Would you like this bicycle? So here the bicycle is a noun and we are having this with this sentence. In second sentence you can see again that is occurred before car. I don't want these accolades. These word is coming before allocates. Now come on the descriptive adjective. Descriptive, it means who gives the description of something. It is just like your qualitative adjective. Okay. Next one, that is distributive adjective. Those who are not able to understand distributive adjective, kindly pay attention. Okay. Distributive adjectives point out the specific identities. Listen to me carefully, class. Nobody will speak out. Listen to me. Those who are distributive adjective, actually they distribute the identity of something. Look at this. These are the example. It means they want to draw the attention of someone. Like, let me say you, any, each, either, every, neither. These words are having some specific meaning. The word any, it means that any of something. If I say that any country, if I say any country, it means it may include India, it may include Pakistan, it may include America, it may include, it means any country of the world can be included. If I say any boy of class 8, it means I am talking about any of them. Okay? So the word any is used to distribute. It means to separate the person with other. The person with other. Next one, each. What is the difference between any and each? Can anyone tell me the Hindi meaning of any and each?
Their elders. What is the difference between both of them?
They means same. They means same. But there is a
I'm not even able to spell.
Yes, beta.
Now what is the spelling of penny?
Penny, P-E-N-N-Y. P-E-N-N-Y. Okay. Let me speaking what was I was saying. Look, what is the difference between each and every? जब हम कहते हैं every, इसका मतलब होता है most of the member of the group. और अगर हम कहते हैं each, इसका मतलब हम सभी के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं. जैसे मैंने कहा कि एवरी स्टूडेंट शुड वेयर यूनिफॉर्म, इट मीन्स मोस्ट और आई एम सेइंग दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट शुड वेयर यूनिफॉर्म. ओके, अगर मैं कहूँ ईच स्टूडेंट शुड वेयर यूनिफॉर्म, इसका मतलब मैं एक कंपल्शन लगा रही हूँ, मैं एक ऑब्लिगेशन बता रही हूँ कि सभी बच्चों को यूनिफॉर्म पहनना चाहिए. इसका मतलब कोई भी ऐसा ना हो जिसने यूनिफॉर्म ना पहनी हो. ठीक है, तो ये क्या हो गया, कंपल्शन हो गया. क्या हो गया, कंपल्शन हो गया, एक नेसेसिटी हो गई. लेकिन अगर हम एवरी लगा देते हैं तो इसका मतलब मोस्ट ऑफ देम हो जाता है. क्या हो जाता, मोस्ट ऑफ देम. और जैसे मैं कहूँ एवरी इंडियन स्पीक्स हिंदी, इसका मतलब व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द इंडियन स्पीक्स हिंदी. एंड इफ आई से दैट ईच इंडियन स्पीक्स हिंदी, दैट विल बी रॉन्ग. Because in India there are many languages and some of the people are there who even don't know how to speak Hindi. They know only their own language, own local language. Am I right or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Just like that, I can say that each, the word each and every having different means. Okay, now come on the next one, that is indefinite adjectives. Look, these are very important to know. Indefinite adjectives are used when we are not able to know about the real and certain number and certain quantity of something. There are two types of quantities, those who are countable, those who are uncountable. Okay, those who are countable, they can be counted, but if we are not having time and if we don't have any data, a certain data of any amount, that time we will speak, we will use some unclear words, some vague words. Those vague words are any, few, many, no, and several. These are any, few, many, no, and several. These are the indefinite adjectives. Okay?
Ma'am, please tell indefinite adjective again.
Again, I'm telling. Those adjectives who are used in the place of some certain amount that we don't know. Let me give you one example. Class, because you all are not coming to the school. Am I right? And your attendance is being taken by us, but most of you in this class are not knowing how many children in your class. How many children in your class? If somebody asks you that how many, what is the strength of your class, what you will say? You are not able to tell. So that time you will say that mama, they are. More than 40 children in my class. Okay, you will give her a lump sum data, you will tell. Just like that, if you are not knowing that how many pencil you have, or if you are not going to count them, if somebody asks you that how many pencils do you have, so you will say that I have few pencils. I will say that I have few pencils. Because I am not going to count them. I am not having any perfect data. That time I will say that I have few pencils. I can say I have few pens. It means I have some pens, but I am not going to tell you what exact number I am having of pens. Class, aaya samajh mein? Did you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Beta,
speak again.
Ma'am, what is the several?
Several means many, beta. Several means many. Now you are asking that why when many and several both are different. Okay. Let me tell you. Listen to me carefully. Look. If I use any, that means that very little. If I use any, that means very little. And it is generally used in the negative way. Let me tell you one thing. Here in the example also you can see, I don't want any backtop. देखो जब भी एनी वर्ड आएगा वो ज्यादातर नेगेटिव के साथ ही आता है, नॉट के साथ आता है, कभी भी अकेला नहीं आता बच्चों, ठीक है। इसकी खास बात ये होती है कि ये किसी भी जगह एक नेगेटिव इफेक्ट देने के लिए ही यूज किया जाता है। जैसे मैं बोलूँ आई डोंट हैव एनी, ज्यादातर एनी वर्ड तभी यूज करते हैं जब हम निगेटिव बोलते हैं, लेकिन इनका जब हम लोग अलग से यूज करते हैं, इसका अलग अलग जगह अलग अलग यूज होता है, लेकिन इसका ज्यादातर यूज किसी भी निगेटिव बात को कहने के लिए किया जाता है। अभी तुम जब एग्जाम्पल्स हल करोगे यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टूड। ओके, नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज फ्यू। फ्यू का मतलब मैंने अभी बताया, आई हैव फ्यू पेंसिल्स। इफ यू डोंट नो हाउ मेनी एग्जैक्ट नंबर यू आर हैविंग द पेंसिल, दैट टाइम यू कैन से आई हैव फ्यू पेंसिल्स। मेनी इट मीन्स इफ यू हैव मेनी पेंसिल्स, अ लॉट ऑफ पेंसिल्स। If you have a lot of pencils, that time you say it means more than enough. Many means more than enough. If you have, it means if you are using only 4 or 5 pencils and if you are having 10 and 11 pencils, that time you can say that I have many pencils. It means if I lost 1 or 2, 3 pencils, it doesn't matter for me. That time I can say I have many pencils. If I am saying that I have many toys, it means I have enough toys more than my need. If I say no, I have no pencil, it means there is nothing. There is nothing. And if I say several, several means a variety of kind. It means like, let me tell you one thing. If I say that I have several pencils, and if I say I have many pencils, many is a common word to tell about that I have pencils. But if I say that I have several pencils, it means I have many qualities pencils. Like I have one Apsara pencil, I have one Boms pencil, one is from Natraj company, one is from Reynolds company, one is from... It means I have different qualities of pencil. If I say I have several cars, it means I have one Toyota car, I have one Suzuki car, I have one Maruti car, I have one Tata car. It means I have several qualities of the same group. Class, you understand what is the difference between many and several?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, come on next. That is interrogative adjective. Interrogative adjectives poses a question. These are very few. Those are what, which and whose. They will always come with some noun. These are some examples. Some example are, what color do you want to paint the cottage? What you will give the answer? If you want to know any color name, you will ask that which color or what color. Am I right? You will ask what? What color or which color? Okay? Only two words you can use to ask someone to get the name of the quality. If you want to know about which quality you are asking, you will use what or which word for the adjectives. You can see the examples here. What color do you want to paint the college? Here the word color is with what. यहाँ पहले सेंटेंस में आपको वर्ड के साथ कलर दिख रहा है ना, कैन यू सी? इसमें देखो कलर क्या है आपका नाउन है और वर्ड क्या है आपका क्वेश्चनिंग वर्ड है। जब कोई क्वेश्चनिंग वर्ड किसी भी नाउन के साथ आता है तो समझ जाना कि वहां पर वो क्वेश्चनिंग वर्ड कोई प्रोनाउन नहीं है, वो क्या है? एडजेक्टिव है। क्या है? एडजेक्टिव। इसके बाद दूसरा है विच किमोनो डू यू वांट टू ऑर्डर। अब यहाँ पे किमोनो क्या है? नाउन है। बेटा ये कुछ खाने की चीज होती है, ठीक है? हम नहीं खाते हैं, मतलब इंडिया में लोग नहीं खाते हैं। जापान में बच्चों बहुत ही खूबसूरत ड्रेस होती है, लोग पहनते हैं। आप लोगों ने देखा होगा, मैं आप लोगों को किमोनो दिखा देती हूँ। इट इज ट्रेडिशनल वेडिंग ड्रेस यू कैन से इन जापान। यस, कैन यू सी द पिक्चर ऑफ किमोनो? दिस इज द ट्रेडिशनल वेयर। दिस इज द ट्रेडिशनल, ऑन द राइट साइड यू कैन सी दिस इज द ट्रेडिशनल वेयर ऑफ जापान दैट इज कॉल्ड किमोनो। एक्चुअली आई ऑल्सो डोंट नो अबाउट किमोनो, सॉरी क्लास। सो Now, next is the whose land are we standing on? It is talking about that of which person the land is. Of which person the land is. It means it is asking about the person's name whose land is there. So, the three word what, which and whose. These are the words which can be used as adjective, interrogative adjective. Although we know that these words are interrogative words, is it? They are interrogative words, but they are used in these sentences as adjective. Why? Because they are coming with some noun. They are coming with some noun. Now next, that is possessive adjective. Possessive adjective class, this is very important to know because sometimes you may get confused about the use of possessive pronoun and possessive adjective because sometimes they are same. Like for every person, person samajh rahe ho, person matlab first person, second person and third person, in teenon ke liye hi possessive adjective और possessive pronoun में थोड़ा बहुत difference कम होता है, इसलिए आपको समझना पड़ेगा। जैसे his word जो है आपका, ये भी possessive adjective है, इसका use हम कब करते हैं? जब हमें बोलना होता है his pen, her pen, my pen, our pen, their pen, your pen, just like that, his house, her house, my house, our house, their house, your house. So they will also come with some noun. Understood class? But somewhere in the sentences they will come alone. Whenever these words will come alone, that means in that sentence they are used as pronoun. They are used as pronoun. जैसे इसमें से आपका जो word his है, listen to me carefully again. इसमें से जो word his है ना आपका, ये आपका प्रोनाउन भी होता है और एडजेक्टिव भी होता है। फिर से सुनो मिलकर, इन सारे वर्ड्स में से आपका जो वर्ड हिज है, ये आपका प्रोनाउन भी होता है और एडजेक्टिव दोनों होता है, ठीक है? आपको समझना पड़ेगा कि ये कब प्रोनाउन की तरह काम कर रहा है, कब एडजेक्टिव की तरह। और ये आप कैसे पता लगाओगे? व्हेन एवर द वर्ड हिज विल कम विद सम एडजेक्टिव, सॉरी सम नाउन, that time it is acting as adjective. और अगर ये अकेले आएगा तो समझ जाना कि यहाँ पर ये pronoun काम कर। आइए आपके समझ में। अब हम लोग काम करते हैं, example देखते हैं। Is that their Ferrari? Don't touch our Bugatti. I am sorry, I didn't know this was your Lamborghini. ठीक है? All the sentences are okay. अब देखो यहाँ पर तुम्हें प्रोनाउन का भी दिया हुआ है।
बुगाटी
बुगाटी name of the company of car beta? Bugatti Veyron. There is a company of car, very nice car they are having, and very costly cars are there. So Ferrari, Bugatti and Lamborghini, these all are very high profile and high professional cars, you know. So these are the name of the companies of cars. Okay, next one, it is written here, his, hers, mine, ours, theirs and yours. Listen to me carefully. These are pronouns. These are pronouns. ऊपर जो दिए थे वो adjectives थे बच्चों, और जो नीचे दिए हुए हैं वो pronoun हैं। फिर से सुन लो। ऊपर जो दिए थे वो adjectives थे, ये जो दिए हैं ये pronoun हैं। क्यों? क्योंकि ज़्यादातर क्या पीछे क्या लगा हुआ है? S लगा हुआ है। अगर S लगा दोगे तो pronoun बन जाएगा, और S नहीं लगाओगे तो adjective रहेगा। आया आपका समझ में?
Yes, ma'am.
अब इसमें से ये आपके काम के नहीं है, प्रॉपर एडजेक्टिव आपके काम के नहीं है, क्वांटिटेटिव पढ़ा चुकी हूँ मैं। अब हाँ, अब नाउ आई एम गिविंग यू एन एक्सरसाइज, काइंडली सॉल्व इट। ओके
मैम, इन पेन कॉपी?
नो नो, इन रफ कॉपी राइट नाउ।
ओके मैम।
Finally take the screenshot.